But we can keep admiring the stock moves and the business models that these are. Let's also chat with JK Paper. A.S. Mehta, the president of JK Paper, joins in. Mr. Mehta, morning. Walk us through your numbers. What have been the highlights? You've seen some strong operational performance. What would you attribute that to?
When you are talking about the EBITDA percentage increase and the absolute amount of EBITDA, it has increased from 97 to 151 crore for the quarter. Year as a whole also, the increase is substantial increase and 539 odd crore. So there are few factors, and one is that the sales volume is higher, but at the same time the raw material cost is lower, and predominantly lower raw material cost is because of the raw material from the nearby area, reducing the logistics cost, so the raw material cost is lower. Our efficiency parameters are better than even the previous quarters. Previous quarters were better than the last year. So in fact, in this quarter our EBITDA percentage improved because of the usage and the efficiency parameters very strongly. In fact, our power consumption, water consumption, energy consumption, all these consumptions are best in class, and best our own record wise is the best today. We have improved our product mix, and higher pricing product are more, so the product mix enrichment has also given a better NSR, and also the paper prices were higher. So effectively our NSR due to product mix as well as the price increase is higher by something around 4%. So that has also given advantage in the quarter. Our capacity utilization in the quarter is better, and in fact our new machine, our capacity utilization is almost 110%. So that also has added in the efficiency parameter and consequently to the EBITDA percentage.
Well, given the recent ban on petcoke volatility and other raw material prices, how do you think raw material cost will move going forward?
As far as we are concerned, our raw material is predominantly the wood, because we are wood based pulp and paper integrated plant. So the wood cost, if it goes down or if it goes up, that impacts the profitability. In fact, during the year wood cost has come down. As I said that we did the massive plantation in the close by area. Since we are sourcing from the close by area, our logistics cost is lower and consequently the raw material cost is lower. Going forward in 18, 19, 17, 18, I mean all these years to come, I would say that since we did the massive plantation in last 4 years, so we will continue to get the advantage of the sourcing of raw material from the close by area. So our raw material cost should remain stable, or it should soften to some more extent. As far as the petcoke, as you mentioned, is concerned, in fact we use petcoke as a fuel partly in our kiln. The lime kiln we use the petcoke, and this has given some adverse impact, but on overall cost basis we still have the advantage of the energy consumption, because our coal consumption has come down, our power consumption has come down, so we still have saved substantial money on the energy front.
Right. So what are the realizations, and given the increase in paper prices by, you know, a good 10%, what is the outlook on pricing going forward?
As I said that we have rejigged our product mix, because we thought that there are value added product and there are specialty paper. So in fact we have improved the volume of a specialty paper, increasing the weighted average the NSR, but the paper prices, I would say that there are broad four categories of paper where we operate. The copier paper prices have not moved much, because there is a competition, and also the demand supply scenario is a fairly balanced, but the paper prices have not moved in copier category, and the prices will likely to remain stable, and there may be some opportunity later on, because the June, May and June, these are the two slack months, because the school, colleges and the courts are closed, so the demand also remains lower. So these 2 months I don't think that there will be any correction in the prices, but in time to come there may be some upward revision in the copier prices. As far as the white wood-free paper is concerned, which is used in the publication and the books and notebooks, the prices were bullish. In fact, there were price increases in last 6 months. But in the month of May and June, and possibly the July also, the off-season starts. So there won't be any price increase. There may be some price drop marginally, but we are not a very big major player in this category. As far as the packaging board is concerned, there is no price increase at this point of time, and I would say that the demand supply scenario remains the supply more than the demand, so the price increase happening is not a possibility in the near future.
Okay, finally tell us, you know, South Indian paper mills have been shutting down because of water shortage. What is the impact on sales from this, and if you could leave us with a guidance for FY18?
See, the shutting of the South Indian mill, it was partly true, I would say. The TNPL, we understand that some production was impacted because of the water shortage, but it was not a major impact. Yes, this would have impacted in the local South market, but it was not a pan-India impact, I would say. The impact was more because of the other player, the name you used earlier. So that was the major impact, but they have restarted now. That's one part. As far as the 17-18 is concerned for JK Paper as such, I would say that we'll continue to do the product mix correction, and we will be moving towards more and more value-added product.
Okay, good to hear that. That's JK Paper highlighting the financial numbers. 2% higher is where it's currently at in trade. What about the rest of the market? Continues to consolidate. That's okay. We're not complaining at all. The breadth may be a little negative, but again, that is also completely fine with us considering how hard the run-up has been off late.